Amid public clamor for government response during and in the aftermath of consecutive deadly typhoons in the country, Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte created yet another task force to streamline disaster response and rehabilitation efforts. A move slammed by critics for its redundancy with a National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council. But Malacanang insists the Build Back Better task force is different from the NDRRMC. Duterte spokesman Harry Roque says it will be dedicated to post-disaster rehabilitation and recovery, while the NDRRMC will coordinate risk and rescue operations.
So wala naman pong superfluity. It will facilitate the easier and the faster provision of relief and assistance pag meron pong kalamidad. Well, itong sunod-sunod na kalamidad naman po, makes the task force a necessity already. No? Dahil ang gusto lang talaga ni Presidente mas mabilis na pagbigay ng pangangailangan natin mga kababayan kapag meron pong kalamidad.
The new task force will be led by the Office of Executive Secretary Salvador Medial Dea.
Miski walang pagpupulong ng council, pwede na magdesisyon ang executive secretary, no? Lalong-lalo na if it means saving lives. Direkta na si ES na magsasabi, hanap pondo, DBM, and National Treasurer, please release the funds.
But for governance experts, creating a new task force is not the way to go. Attorney Tony Lavinia explains, a task force is superfluous since the NDRRMC is empowered under the law to lead disaster response. For Dean Ronald Mendoza of the Ateneo School of Government, new agencies that are not guided by evidence-based plans and research will not make a difference, especially if it is staffed by what Mendoza calls incompetent loyalists. For Vice President Lenny Robredo, opening up a new agency will just create new levels in the bureaucracy.
Bubukas ng bagong agency na meron namang existing, so baka it would be worth studying. Yung existing agency, ano ba yung kakulangan nito? Ba yung kakulangan ng existing agency? Para kung may kulang, baka kaya naman ng legislation. Ito ngayon nire-reklamo ni na Governor Albano na parang ang dami-daming different agencies na gumagawa ng kanya-kanya.
Robredo is also seeking a probe into the historic and deadly flooding in Cagayan. The province was submerged in floods brought about by Typhoon Ulysses and the subsequent release of water from the Magat Dam. Robredo believes there was an oversight, even if the flooding was triggered by various factors.
Meron bang existing na estimate? Kung halimbawa, one gate yung bubuksan, alin yung may in danger of flooding? Kung three gates yung bubuksan, alin? At least yung kausap ko, hindi niya alam. Para sa akin, hindi ba alam ng mga taga doon na pag seven gates yung nakabukas, alin na mga lugar yung mababa?
But Malacanang says there were no shortcomings in the government's response to Ulysses.
We will strive to do better, pero sa tingin ko po, wala naman pong pagkukulang.
Roque adds the government prepared for Ulysses' onslaught in Cagayan Valley, but he cites climate change, deforestation, and illegal mining as the cause of the flooding in the region. The official death toll from Typhoon Ulysses has risen to at least 69, making it the deadliest storm to hit the Philippines so far this year. The NDRRMC is recommending to place the entire Luzon under a state of calamity. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.